What is up, YouTube? It's Chris Lee back again with another video. Right now I'm at the Volvo out here in Dallas. My truck has been acting up for a little bit. It's been acting up for like a month or so. I took it to Jordan. I think I told y'all, I took it to Jordan. They looked at it and they said it was all good. But what's been going on is it thinks that there's like low coolant in the truck, but the coolant's full. There's no coolant leaks, nothing like that. And everything, you know what I'm saying, good until the truck figures that there's no coolant. And then I'll be like going 65 down the road. And then it'll stall, like it'll idle. Where I push the pedal and like it won't go nowhere. And like the speed will start coming down drastically, like from 60 to 40. So I had to get it over here and I had to get it looked at. So that's where I'm at now, but in this video. I put out a couple days ago that I wanted to talk to y'all about me and my first year at Jordan Carriers. Alright, so I've been putting out like videos periodically about Jordan Carriers and talking about my experience. So I'm going to just go ahead and go off of like some of the information that I've told y'all already. Just thinking about what's been going on. You know, it's been real cool over here at Jordan. I've had any issues. I've had any, you know what I'm saying? Nothing crazy, nothing too crazy going on. Just, you know what I'm saying? Everything that I've had going on, you know what I mean? It was cool. Like, I haven't been to Jordan. It's been like a year since I've been over there. So I went not too long ago. And I was able to see some of the supporters of my channel. I got to see some people out there in Natchez. I went two times, actually. I went to go pick up a trainee. Well, I didn't go to pick up a trainee, but I picked up a trainee and I brought him back. So I went twice. That was more than I've been there ever. So like my third time there since being hired. But you know what I'm saying? I got to go meet some of y'all and see some of y'all. That was real cool. A lot of people are getting hired at Jordan, you know what I'm saying, off watching my videos. So if you want to put me down as a reference, Chris Carter, you know what I'm saying, that's just, if you want to, I'm going to just put it out there. I'm not going to turn down the free money. But I actually got one of my homies off Twitter. I forget where he was at, but you know what I'm saying, I think he was at Prime or somewhere. He was at some flatbed company. He's in orientation right now. So shout out to Eric. He's in orientation right now. I think he's got like two, considered like two guys out of four that was in the orientation class. That's pretty small, right? So shout out to Eric. Can't wait till you get out here. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, there was somebody had asked me a question about. Well, I had put up a poll, and I asked y'all if y'all wanted me to drop this video. So, like, a lot of people said yes. The haters said no. And then one guy commented that he was like, go ahead and drop the video. Because a lot of people want to know about the drug test at Jordan. So, when I went to Jordan, actually, I just recently went to Jordan and had to take a urine analysis. Tests. That's kind of what they do at Jordan, as far as my knowledge goes. My last test was urine analysis. My first test there was urine analysis. So that's pretty much answering that question. If y'all have any other questions about Jordan, go ahead and drop them in the comments. But like I said, I'm here getting my truck fixed, getting it worked on. You know what I'm saying? Loving the job, appreciate the job. I don't know. Y'all tell me, am I a flatbed driver, like a real flatbed driver? Because I'm on this dedicated account. Like, when I went to Jordan and I talked to some of the drivers and I could see, like, what was on their flatbed truck, like, I could see their load, I felt like, you know what I'm saying, not less of a truck driver, but, you know what I'm saying, what they do and what I do is two totally different things. You know what I'm saying? That's like a whole new like I'm in a pond and they in the ocean, right? Like I'm a fish in the pond and they fish in the ocean. And that's just pretty much how it is. Like I'm not even gonna lie. Because like just looking at the lows that they do and the lows that I do, it's two totally different things. I don't do half of the stuff they do. Everything I do, like I know, it's pretty much routine. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna do some spools. I'm gonna do some 60-foot rebar, 40-foot rebar. I'm not doing. Everything is routine. It's nothing out of the norm. I might do some T-posts every now and then. I might, you know what I'm saying, haul some bags of material, like ash or something, and strap that and tarp that down. But other than that, some scrap metal. I promise you, that's all I do. Like, within a week, I'm not doing anything outside of that. But the actual flatbed drivers for Jordan, like, there's no telling what you're going to get. You know what I'm saying? You get what you get, right? You're not going to know. You know what I'm saying? It's not as consistent. It's not as, you know what I'm saying? They can't be like, okay, I know what I'm going to get. Maybe, like, if they're in proximity of somewhere, like, if they're, like, in Louisiana, they'd be like, okay, I know who our shippers are in Louisiana, or who our shippers are in Lake Charles, or who our receivers are in Lake Charles, and stuff like that. Like, people over the road, and I swear, like, I put my hat, I salute y'all, for real. First, I want to do a moment of silence, you know what I'm saying, for, like, a lot of stuff that's been going on, you know what I'm saying, and within our community. So I'm going to go ahead and do that real quick. But yeah, there's been a lot of stuff going on, and I'm gonna keep that stuff to myself and all the politics and stuff inside my house. You know, I'm not gonna bring it to the YouTube channel, but y'all know, you know what you know, right? But yeah, my hat is off to all the flatbed drivers, because you know what I'm saying, y'all really out there doing it, and yeah. Y'all can have that, because I ain't trying to do that. I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying, stay over here, stay in my lane, you know what I'm saying? I hope y'all know that, like, on this ride, I go home every weekend, you know, give ands and buts, you know what I'm saying, you know, arguing with dispatch. That's why I like it so much over here. I can brag. Not really boast, but, like, let y'all know that this is, like, a great job over here. That's why I'm always talking about Jordan. That's why I brag about Jordan, because, you know what I'm saying, they pay me every week. They, you know what I'm saying, it's never a shortage of loads. Even through the whole quarantine thing, everything has been going good. Like, I had nothing, no hiccups or nothing like that. And people ask me, like, you know what I'm saying, when I get my Uber to go home and stuff like that, and like, you know what I'm saying, have you seen anything as far as, like, your freight stopping or any issues? And I have none. Like, I can't even think of a time, you know what I'm saying, unless I was getting my truck worked on. I haven't stopped, right? There hasn't been no call where they'd be like, oh, Chris, we don't have no loads right now. You just gonna have to sit. You gonna have to chill until we find something for you. Like, I had that issue. I had that at Stevens. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes that will happen at Stevens Transport, but, like, never over here on the dedicated account doing flatbed at Jordan have I had, you know what I'm saying, like, literal downtime. I have never waited. I remember one time I was stuck in Florida, and I waited, like, 3 days to get a load. 3 days. Like, that was insane. And that's, you know what I'm saying, that's what kind of turned me off from doing that OTR stuff. Like, that's unacceptable. 3 days without money, that's, you know what I'm saying, that's a lot of money out here if you're trucking. You know what I'm saying? We run about a week. So when that weekly check came and I was short 3 days, I didn't have 3 days on my check. You know what I'm saying? Things wasn't looking too good. But like I said, everything out here is great. They're very prompt over here at Jordan. They get everything done. Like, if you stay below the radar, I'm telling you, stay below the radar. You know what I'm saying? Do what you're supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? And you're not, ain't nobody gonna mess with you. You're gonna be good. Don't be like me. But on that note, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video out. It is your boy, Chris Lee. Actually, hold up. Yeah, I'm gonna end this video out. It's your boy, Chris Lee. If you have any questions, go ahead and hit me on my, you know what I'm saying, Instagram DM. Hit me on my Facebook, my Twitter, all that. You know what I'm saying? I respond to all my guys. I respond to everybody. Someone actually asked me to mentor them. Just, you know what I'm saying, on getting through the first year of sucking. If y'all think that I should offer that as a service, or if y'all are interested in that, let me know. You know what I'm saying? I would do it if more people requested it. I might give it some consideration and think about doing it. I know a lot of guys out here, you know what I'm saying, they just need help putting a plan together, help, you know what I'm saying, just some guidance and stuff like that. I wish I had maybe before I started cooking, but it was all good, you know what I'm saying? I fell forward, and there's nothing wrong with having guidance, and there's nothing wrong with coming forward. It's just that I don't want to be a crutch, right? I don't want to be a crutch to guys, and they're like, because what's working for me, like I said, with those flatbed OTR guys, what works for me might not work for them. What works for them might not work for me. Like, just for, like, how I have my money set up. I have $200 automatically taken out my check. I was talking to Eric this week, and he was like, yeah, like, I like having the responsibility, you know what I'm saying, of taking it out myself, because what happens when that job is gone? You know what I'm saying? They're not there to take it out automatically. And I was like, yeah, you're right. But I've tried other ways to save in the past, and this method is working out for me the best. And he was like, yeah, and my method is working out for me the best. And I was like, that's dope. You know what I'm saying? I thought that was cool. Like, I was like, I'm glad that you understand what works for you. And I'm glad that I understand what works for me. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, we're both trying to, you know what I'm saying, do big things. We're both trying to, you know what I'm saying, go to the next level. And it's just whatever works for you is kind of what you have to stick with, right? You got to stick with that at the end of the day. So again, your boy Chris Lee, I'm out. Peace.